Hello from ChemHelp ASAP. Let's quickly introduce some assays, both according to type and function, that are encountered in drug discovery. Upon completion of this video, students will be able to list some classifications of assays and list different roles of assays that are used to identify active compounds during early drug discovery. All assays can be classified as either a functional or binding assay. Functional assays determine the effect or response caused by a molecule. The effect could be almost anything: gene expression, enzyme inhibition, or changes in hormone levels. The potency of a molecule for a functional assay is often reported as an EC50 or IC50 value. Binding assays measure the extent to which a compound binds its target. The potency of a compound is reported as a KD value, which is an equilibrium constant equal to the compound concentration required to reach 50% binding of the target. In a sense, a binding assay is a type of functional assay in which target binding is the function of the compound. Regardless, binding assays are generally discussed separately from functional assays. Early assays in drug discovery are also often divided between biochemical and cellular assays. Biochemical assays do not rely on intact cells for measuring a compound's activity. Biochemical assays include most binding assays and some simple functional assays, for example, enzyme inhibition assays. Cellular assays require intact cells for the assay. For example, if you are monitoring the action of a compound on a membrane-bound receptor, then you will very likely need a cellular assay. Cellular assays are generally more technically challenging than a biochemical assay because the assay conditions must be mild enough to tolerate living cells. Both biochemical and cellular assays are types of in vitro assays. Okay, let's now discuss four different assay types classified based on the role of each in early discovery. First, we have the primary assay. The primary assay is the main testing tool to discover active molecules. The primary assay is often a relatively fast functional assay. Next, we have the counter assay. A counter assay identifies whether a molecule interferes with the proper function of the primary assay. These interfering molecules might be false positives. An orthogonal assay uses a different method for detecting activity in the primary assay in order to confirm the results of the primary assay. For example, the primary assay, an enzyme inhibition assay, might measure the rate of reaction by UV detection of the product formation. An orthogonal assay might detect product formation by mass spectrometry. Finally, a secondary assay is a completely different assay that monitors changes downstream in the biological pathway relative to the primary assay. A secondary assay is more likely to be a cellular assay. Ultimately, the secondary assay confirms activity observed in the primary assay. I hope it is clear that when researchers test molecules for biological activity, multiple different types of assays are used to ensure that the observed activity in the primary assay is valid and leads to meaningful changes in the biological pathway of interest. We have listed some ways to classify types of assays, such as biochemical or cellular assays. We have also listed some different roles that assays fulfill based on the information that they provide during early drug discovery. I hope this video gave you a better understanding of the general types and usages of assays in drug discovery. Please leave a like, make a comment, or subscribe to the channel. Take care.